Hi, this is James Stone from jamesstone.com, and in this video I want to talk a little bit about what are some differences, at least key differences, between ZURB Foundation and Bootstrap, formerly known as Twitter Bootstrap. So you might be thinking, you know, going between these different frameworks that they're very similar, that maybe a lot of the different features seem to have a lot of parity, and you know, there is. In fact, Bootstrap and Foundation largely do the same thing, and they speed up your workflow, give you a common set of CSS and JavaScript components to kind of build from, but there are some minor differences, so I want to point those out and tell you, you know, why you would really want to choose one over the other. So one thing you could look at is just look at the mission statement of each project. So for example, Bootstrap is really more focused in creating apps that look very similar to each other. So a consistent look and feel, a consistent user interface. And it tends to have a very kind of opinionated design that's kind of ready to go out of the box. So this is really fantastic. Let's say you're a Ruby developer, you do mostly backend, and you want to make your designs look a little bit more designed without having to do a lot of work. You just want them to look a little bit more polished. Bootstrap is a fantastic way to go because you don't really have to do too much beyond using the components, the way they're designed. So Foundation was actually designed by ZURB, which is a design agency. And so, like its name, Foundation, it's designed to be more of a foundation for your apps. So there is a little bit more involved with design, but the advantage here is that you have a lot more flexibility in what types of designs and the ways that you can use Foundation, and it's a little bit less opinionated, so you can really revamp the way the buttons are looking very, very quickly without doing a lot of overrides and this type of thing. So another really important thing, so if you're working on a team, you might be thinking about using a front-end framework such as ZURB Foundation or Twitter Bootstrap, but one of the key reasons to do that is so that you have this consistent code base, right? So everyone's using the same button, so everyone's using a similar grid, and so there's a lot of great things that can come out of that. So you have this great consistency, everyone kind of learns one tool, and then you can kind of move on. So if you're running a business, one thing that there's really a clear advantage with Foundation is that ZURB actually offers paid support options. Now, ZURB Foundation is an MIT licensed open source framework, so you can use it for anything you want according to that license, but they do offer priority support. So I think it's $100 per incident, and there's different ways in which you can work with like the ZURB Foundation core team. So that's a really fantastic resource to have available to you, and I don't know that Bootstrap really has that exact same thing. However, one really nice thing about Bootstrap is it is the more popular framework, so there is a lot more information online about it. So if you're going on Stack Overflow, you're looking for templates, you're looking for examples on how to do certain things, there tends to be more examples and more detailed examples of how to do that with Bootstrap. But I will caution you, because it's more popular, there also tends to be a lot of really bad examples. So not all of the examples are really polished, and so you have to kind of take it with a grain of salt. When you find, you know, some certain template, make sure it looks and works the way that you intend it to. So another really important thing to consider when you're thinking about ZURB Foundation or Twitter Bootstrap is thinking about mobile. Now, both are mobile responsive frameworks, front-end frameworks, and both have supported a mobile first workflow for quite some time. However, there are some key differences, and some of this is my opinion, so let me just be upfront and by telling you that. So in my opinion, having used both frameworks for quite some time, ZURB Foundation was the first to go mobile first, and there's a big emphasis on having a great mobile user experience when you're building out a site or app with ZURB Foundation. For example, a lot of the sliders and all this type of thing, they're already kind of touch enabled. They're really thought of, I think, from the mobile perspective first, but also to work well on desktop. And again, this is my opinion, this is not exact, but for Twitter Bootstrap, it tends to be the opposite, and it tends to have more emphasis on the desktop interface, and you'll see lots of widgets and all sorts of like really fantastic things. So if you're building a desktop interface and you don't want to spend a lot of time to build out your own components, Bootstrap might be the framework for you. However, when you start going into the mobile area of things, they tend to be like things are just a little bit less refined. So the way that you're working with the different components and the way that they look and the way that you interact on a mobile device is not quite as good in some cases, and it's definitely thought of, I think, more as like an afterthought. So people kind of, it seems like they're coming in from the tail end and refining it for mobile, whereas ZURB seems to be taking the opposite approach, which is to really make sure it's really polished on mobile and then maybe refining so it works well on desktop as well. So along with that, another really key difference, at least between, you know, ZURB Foundation 5 and Bootstrap 3, is the number of grids and the amount of refinement there. So I know Foundation has added a couple of things to help with this, but Foundation tends to have basically three modes, if you want to call it that. There's the desktop, the large, there's the tablet, which is medium, which also tends to be desktop on also small laptop screens, right? And then you have basically small, which is the mobile responsive layout, right? And so, you know, mobile phones are all sorts of different sizes, but when you start designing for mobile, often you're looking at 320 pixels wide, or maybe a little bit wider. And that's kind of like what you're stuck with. And there's some refinement there, there's some additional presentational classes, there's some additional, you know, the visibility classes, there's media queries that you can use for whether it's desktop or landscape and this type of thing. But you tend to have kind of like a refinement of three. And I find when I'm working mostly, it's actually within two, and I tend to use the medium grid, and it maps out to desktop, and the smaller grid, and then it's just about refinement. Like sometimes those choices need to be refined a little bit. So Bootstrap, on the other hand, has a lot more control over this, and so it's a little bit of a double-edged sword. So yes, it does offer a little bit more refinement, a little bit more control. You have this like extra small, extra large. And so you have these little refinements as you get smaller and smaller in screen size. But I think, I mean, at least in my opinion, it can be a lot of work to try and maintain those and make them look and work well on all of those different sizes, right? So I think what you really want to do is think about which kind of mode of working works best for you. Are you thinking more like mobile responsive and I'm going to do some desktop refinement, but I'm not going to be getting in and tweaking for each individual device? Well, then maybe Foundation offers something for you. And for Bootstrap, if you really want to get in and start refining, like for the device, really for those different viewport sizes, it gives you a lot more control. So more of like a manual transmission, so to speak. So another thing to think about in terms of frameworks is maybe, I'll say, the culture of the community. And you know, to be honest, when I first started working with ZURB Foundation, this was the major draw for me. I've always been a fan of the underdog. I've always been a little bit quirky and a little bit nerdy. And I'm just going to say it. ZURB Foundation was a lot more fun for me because they had all sorts of references to Starship Galactica and Star Trek, all this kind of like weird nerd humor kind of embedded within their examples, and they kind of had a fun way of talking about the framework. Now, this can backfire sometimes when you're trying to get buy-in, right? And you have stakeholders that are very like corporate focused, and they really want it to sound kind of very serious and very structured. So in that case, Bootstrap could be really the best choice for you, because when I first started using Bootstrap and ZURB Foundation, that was a big turnoff for me because I'm kind of not a big corporate guy. Obviously, like I'm not, you know, super corporate. But for some people, they really like that. So when you read the documentation about Bootstrap and any sort of, you go to the Bootstrap website, it's like very clean. It's kind of almost clinical, very kind of corporate in its nature. Whereas if you go to ZURB Foundation, you'll see like Yetis, and it's like kind of fun and kind of free flowing, and it's just a really different type of culture. So culture could play a really important part in making your decision. For example, maybe if you're building sites for the government or libraries, they might not appreciate that kind of fun culture that ZURB has. However, maybe if you're dealing with clients or stakeholders that are in the music industry, that are in design or art, it would appeal that kind of quirky, fun, design-focused culture of ZURB. All right. So another thing to think about is if you're an independent developer like myself, or maybe you're getting started with development and you're thinking about a career, one other thing that's really nice about ZURB Foundation is they do offer a certification. So this is not something that is offered in Bootstrap. So the question becomes, one, if you're going to hire a developer, how do you know if they know what they're doing in Bootstrap? Well, I'm sure you would have to test them and go through some sort of extensive interview process and make sure they actually know what they're talking about. But what's really nice with ZURB Foundation, and I'm actually ZURB Foundation Certified Preferred, is that they have this certification program. And it works by, one, you have to give back to the community, right, and answering questions and doing this type of thing. And then two, you have to go through this extensive examination process where they actually make sure you know how to create websites in ZURB Foundation. And it's pretty extensive, and it was challenging. It was challenging even for myself. So that is a fantastic thing to think about. If you're an independent developer, maybe you're starting your career, or if certifications are like an important part of what you do in your career, there's really no certification process in Bootstrap. So clearly there, I think ZURB Foundation has an advantage. And so, in conclusion, I've given you some reasons, you know, obviously, why I think Foundation is fantastic, and obviously I am biased, and I do happen to have a preference for that framework for a lot of use cases, but I'll tell you, if there was a good reason, a compelling reason to use Bootstrap over Foundation for a particular project, I would definitely use that. I'm not going to force myself to use some sort of tool that's not really the right tool for the job. So if you're considering both these frameworks, what I would encourage you to do is just kind of look and see which one appeals to you more, which one is going to fit better with your stakeholders, which one offers maybe a set of components that's going to speed your process, that's going to get you to your goals sooner. Like, are you thinking about mobile first design and doing something pretty edgy and out there, like really cool app? Or are you thinking about, oh, it's really just more like a desktop dashboard and we want it to work on mobile, but that's not the most important part of the project? So you really need to consider all these things and really do some research, maybe watch some videos, maybe do a little reading, and determine which is the best framework for you. So if you have any questions, let me know in the comments, and thank you for watching.